Hello, everybody. Welcome. We are now going to be casting Game 2 of Euthanasia Coaster vs. Hammer Time.
Yeah. I talked to Trevor, Alcatraz swim team, before this game. And it sounded like, I'm going to look at that game right now, but it sounded like their game one, they got dumpstered in. Let me go investigate a little bit.
Interesting.
Which won't be the case this game. I hope this will be a close game. I actually find that RD2L is much more fun when the games are close.
It's way more fun to cast, too.
Yeah. Oh, never mind. I can't see the game because they didn't ticket it either.
Dude, so holy shit. Holy shit. First ban Animage against Alc.
The respect ban coming out. For those unaware, Alcatraz Swim Team plays a mean Anti-Mage. I think it's still his most played hero, even though he hasn't played it a ton recently.
Definitely.
Hasn't been great for a long time.
Here, I need to find
He has 379 games on the Anti-Mage and only 100 on his next most played. So yeah, it's an Alc specialty.
Let's see how many anime lover for lifes there are. Oh, actually, literally just you two. It's
Radiance. Wait, oh, Brody changed his name back. Lil Sebastian on Alc's team was named anime lover for life. We did it together.
Dude, holy shit, Pisces is a drafter.
They're banned Bondi, okay. Wait, actually, is it actually Pisces draft? That's
Pisces
exciting.
Is drafting.
I like that.
Oh, first pick nature.
I like the NP first pick. A hero I think it's probably the second most broken hero other than Lina.
It definitely is, and with the Lina banned out, that makes it a really good pickup. The other thing is that I know buying onions can play it, so they can flex it between.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's
right.
You can flex it one or three. Interesting. Okay, Ursa actually is pretty good versus NP because you can't tree him because Ursa just presses Q and
it is until level 20.
Well, Ursa's gonna build Battle Fury anyway, so it'll be
fine. But even if you cut, you get the leash, it's just trapped. It's
Dire's ban now. I think it's pretty. You can blink on it. Like, if I guess it depends on who's being initiated on. I think it's.
Oh, I like this. I like this tree and pickup.
Yeah, the tree and NP is it's a good combo. The tree is a really good support. They have two really good global presence heroes, you know? Like, if you gank somebody on the side lane, you have to always deal with the plus one Nature's Prophet and yep. them being pre-armored.
Banning out the Zeus to make sure that they can't global. Zeus is good global.
Yeah, and it's also good versus tree because it gives flying. Like, he gives flying vision and he can Nimbus for global vision.
What I really like here, though, is the fact that now they have this Treant and this Prophet, so Ursa's going to have to commit spells in order to get out of things.
Yeah, mm-hmm. He's gonna have to use like when Tree ults him, he's gonna have to use Enrage, or else he'll be stuck there for 3 seconds or whatever, you know.
Yep.
Which means that he's using Enrage to escape instead of using Enrage to blow up your P1.
Yep. And even if he does Enrage, you get seconds. If he enrages before you root, it's just like alright, cool. Left. I'm still rooting him.
Yeah, and you're still rooting him and even if you're only rooting him for a second because he's ulted, that's still a second that he's rooted for, he's not getting Enrage hits on. Also, I think it's interesting, I think RD2L drafts are so interesting because look at Hammer Time's draft, they clearly don't give a shit about the meta. Like, Naga's the only, like, real meta hero they've banned, and, like, Slark a little bit.
Definitely.
I think it's interesting. It seems like they're hard banning out Alc, even though Alc doesn't play Slark. Maybe someone else on their team plays Slark. And Pisces, I think Pisces plays a lot of OD mid, if I remember correctly.
Yes,
I think
he plays,
like, OD and Pango mid a lot, so...
He's a toxic mid laner.
But he's also pretty good versus Ursa, because Ursa like blinks in and tries to blow somebody up and you just press W on him. Or press W on the person he's going on.
Absolutely. 10 seconds. We see the Centaur ban out.
I like the Centaur ban.
Stops people from getting on top of you.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially
you,
trees,
you
found
right?
out. Yeah, as NP, yeah. Mm-hmm. When you are Centaur ulted, you just run straight through the trees and it doesn't your Q does nothing. Also good with Ursa, because Ursa can just sprint at you at 8 trillion movement speed, and you have nothing to do about it.
Oops. I just sent a suicidal bear running after you.
Yeah, actually. Plus, he's got the sick combo where he can put the Warlock in the cart, and the Warlock can channel his,
God, no.
Like, channel ability, and then the Centaur can drive him away.
No, not cart. Don't remind
That's
me.
That's sick.
I have not seen it built in a single game.
I think it's actually trash. I think it's really bad. Viper ban. Weird Viper ban. I know these teams don't play Bristleback, but the only time I ever see a Viper ban is to pick Bristleback.
It's decent against the Ursa.
Is it? I don't know carry matchups. You'll have to inform me, Arkies. Is that?
Just because you can kite him. He gets slowed a bunch from the Viper, as well as just you can't do Fairy swipes if you're broken.
Oh, that's fair. You're broken. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. That's good actually. Pick up Morana. I actually think this is kind of more of a deny pick. Morana works really well with NP because NP can treat somebody and Morana has like 8 seconds to set up an arrow on them. And they have no setup for the Morana right now, which I don't really like. I think they should have picked, I don't know. I feel like this Warlock hero is not good and also doesn't provide setup for either the Ursa or the
really
Morana.
It really doesn't. I feel like it's probably just a comfort pick for whoever their pros 5 is.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah.
Pisces Tusk. Or maybe...
Dude,
no, never mind.
Shit.
Never mind, it's Bungan's Tusk.
This Alk team, the Euthanasia coaster, they have picked every single meta hero possible other than Lina. Like, these are all of the majors, or all the heroes being picked at the major.
Yeah,
this is every single one of them.
And then you look at the bans that Hammer Time has done, it's like, wow.
Yeah, none of those heroes are meta. Like, Naga's the only meta hero there. It's like...
You're wasting a lot of bans on these meta heroes. Well... what you gonna do?
I will say the one thing they are missing is a bit of unless Bat buys Blink, but Bat actually really doesn't like buying Blink all that much. Bat really much prefers to go like Boots of Travel's BKB.
Yeah.
Unless Bat buys Blink, there's not really much initiation on Euthanasia Coaster. Whereas Sand King is a great initiator.
That's the setup too, Sand King Murano.
Yeah, true. That's actually a good lane. Yeah. So it looks like. Are Euthanasia Coaster picking their P4 last? That's interesting.
It's either P4 Tusk. So I think right now they're looking to flex the Tusk between 3 or 4.
Yeah, that's true. Does Pisces, do you know if Pisces plays Tusk?
No, I think he's playing the Bat.
Okay, sure.
I would have to assume that it's most likely a Bat mid.
Arkies, what are you looking for? If you're Hammer Time, what are you looking for in the mid lane to try to counter the Bat Rider?
Right now, they've got the Sand King who really wants to just sit in the lane, so with the Murana behind him. So I think you should get something that rotates around, so maybe like DP that can rotate around for tower push.
I do like DP. They do have NP who's also is good tower damage, so they don't need the tower damage. Oh, sorry. Oh, they don't have MP. They're playing against NP, who has really good tower damage, and they need tower damage.
Yeah, it's like I think
like
right
Golem
now
is like the only good tower hitter in their team. Kind of shit.
And even then, I think Murana is better than Golem.
Yeah, which is depressing.
So I would really like to see something like from the mid lane that can hit towers. Like I don't know.
Yeah, I like DP.
DP just sounds really good here. You. 5 seconds left. You're tanky enough that like you're not gonna get bursted by this Tusk. You don't mind getting lassoed.
It's a good matchup versus Bat too, because A, you don't mind getting lassoed, and B, it's good lane matchup. You're not a melee hero versus Bat, which is like what Bat really preys on.
Absolutely. I think then maybe like the only other hero that I think might be okay for them is like maybe an Invoker.
Arkies, I hate to disagree, but I'm gonna hard disagree on that one. Invoker, I think Invoker is one of the worst mid heroes right now. The numbers on that hero are so low. Like,
true.
He does very little damage.
Oh shit, you're right. Leshrac. Leshrac.
Oh my god.
I'd like to see
right.
DP.
This is the god Leshrac game. Yeah, you're right.
DP or Leshrac.
Yeah. No, actually, I think Leshrac is way better here. I know. I'm totally
like,
agree.
You know, we're looking for like these ranged mids who do tower damage. So.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Viper banned out, you know.
They banned Viper and they banned Drow. I guess both of those heroes are good versus Lesh and Viper. Or Lesh and DP.
Yeah.
They banned Faceless Void though, which makes me think they're picking 5 DP because left. If you're picking Lesh, you don't really care Faceless Void because all your spells are still going off in Chronosphere.
Whereas DP really relies on being able to get that Spirit Siphon off.
Yeah. Mm hmm. Rare Sunshine is also really good against Bat, because if Bat, like, tries to do his, like, fire, Enigma. I think it's called. The...
Alright, so that's Enigma. A 4 Tusk, 3 Enigma.
Yeah.
That's a buying against specialty, the Enigma.
Interesting. They do have Marana. It's like, I guess Sand King's also decent at canceling Black Hole. If Enigma ever gets a BKB, though, then, like...
Warlock. Warlock ulti goes through.
Oh, you're right. Dude, why did they pick... Oh, my God, you're totally right. Why did they pick Enigma here? That seems terrible. They can just hold Warlock ult until Enigma Black Holes, and then he can't ever press Black Hole.
I think right now, the team fight coming out from Hammer Time is just going to be pretty unstoppable if they are able to get ahead in the early game and they can 5-man together.
Yeah.
Like, I don't see, other than Batrider and maybe Tusk.
Yeah, that's... I mean, yeah, it's going to be Tusk 4, though, right? So you're not going to be all that impactful.
This is going to come down to Lasso pulling people out of position or Radiant not being grouped as 5 and just getting picked off.
I do think there is great, like, pick potential with NP and Batrider. Like, NP plus 1 plus either Bat or Tusk is basically a guaranteed kill in any of these heroes other than
Treant.
Ursa.
Treant Prophet is just...
Yeah, true, yeah. Like any of these heroes can plus 1 with the Prophet and kill anyone, so I do think there's good, like, pick-off potential if they don't group as 5 on Radiant.
So...
Here's the Pangolier.
I really don't like it.
They have no building damage. They have 0 building damage. Which I think is the counter to, like, NP and Treant, is you kill Treant's tower so that he can't regen them, because right now, how are you ever going to kill a tree tower? You know, like, tree's going to heal it at 20 per second. There's nothing you can do about it.
You have to kill all 5 before you can take a tower now.
You're literally a tier 1. Yeah, it's interesting. Let's see.
As well as, I don't think it wins the matchup mid.
It definitely loses to Batrider mid. I'm not sure how hard. Pango is, like, surprisingly resilient in lanes.
Pango is resilient, but it's just,
it definitely,
like,
loses. Yeah.
You don't feel good as the Pango if you're just having to sit back and farm.
Yeah, if you're trying to be resilient, you're not, you know, just farming and, like, free farming. Also, if Pango ever uses his, like, Q on a wave,
yeah, if he aggressively Qs, you will die.
Then that instantly just kill him. Yeah. Pango's also weird because you can lasso him when he's rolling, and, like, you can wrestle him at any point, like, even before he starts rolling, and he really, like, is not a hero at that point.
Weird, yeah, just weird. drag it, the new play, drag the roll into some place he can't get out of.
Literally. Drag it, you can drag the roll onto an ob's eye. I guess you can jump off of it, but still. Actually, I like Dire's draft a lot more. I think Dire really outdrafted Radiant here.
I really like Dire's draft. Yeah. I will have to agree with you. It just seems like they have a solid game plan.
Yeah.
You know, shove these waves out with Eidolons, Treants.
With Eidolons plus Treants plus NP, or Nature Prophet's gonna sit in the fucking trees and you know, like, camp the tree line.
Yup. So
are you can I watch your broadcast? I can't. Are you seeing my perspective?
No, I am. So you control your own camera in this.
Ah, okay. So I'll have to just mirror your movements.
Not even. It's nice to have two people because we can be looking at two separate lanes where kills are happening.
True.
Tell the other.
I'll focus on mid, my specialty, where both people are gonna just AFK farm the entire game. That'll be fun. And you can deal with all the action. Since we are picking Lima Major Heroes, we pause. Holy shit.
Alright, coming
so
out here.
I dislike what the what Radiant is doing right now. They're smoking into their own jungle.
They're doing the my team play.
Yeah, I think it's bad for two reasons. One, I don't think if you're Dire, you level 1 attack the Radiant right here, because I think your level 1's way worse.
Oh, definitely. You don't have any stuns level 1.
Yeah, exactly. I think Radiant should be way more aggressive here. And also, they're not going to get the ward mid, and the ward mid's really important. Like, Bat's going to get a free ward down mid, and you're not going to get a ward down mid at all.
Pisces hasn't placed it, but both of them placed this ward up here on the eye.
Dang, they must have seen each other place it, right? Oh yeah, here comes the sentry from Radiant.
Okay, they did in fact see it, and now Bunyan's knows.
Yeah, but he knows there's 5 heroes there, you know, so, like, they're not gonna contest that rune.
Yep, and immediately see the Iron Mask.
Brady can way more aggro. Also, Morana should generally save the arrow for like when someone else gets initiated on, so that you have the follow up.
I guess that he's gonna have it by the time the root's up. So he gets caught here. He does not have leaps. But Dire just doesn't want to fight.
Yeah, you don't want to fight this level one. It's a really good level one.
Free ward for Pisces though.
Yeah, this actually matters a lot in the mid lane matchup. This ward down. Oh, did they see this? Did Tusk see this?
Definitely.
Did they see the ward?
Definitely. There's no way they didn't.
He's got a sentry on him. Is he gonna deward it?
I think he's asking Pisces if Pisces wants him to save it or not.
Oh, okay, yeah, he bought a new ward. Oh, he's gonna drop the ward probably for Pisces, although it still gives the gold.
Oh, no, he gets full duration arrow. It feels bad.
That's funny. Dude, he's already half HP, man. I guess he didn't see that ward because it's still there.
Maybe. Classic Enigma gameplay. No range creep for you.
Yeah, I don't think you understand how obnoxious that is. It's like, I mean, you probably do. You're a safe lane player.
Nate, I'm a carry player. Dumb. It is so obnoxious, and the fact that these Eidolons are already like almost dead by the time Ursa gets to lane, like it means that you don't have a chance to kill them.
You can't even kill the Eidolons to get the 20 gold out of them.
Bungens does get the D ward on that.
Okay, he gets the high one, but he also tanks a million damage for it. But I guess this is fine trading for the Tusk because, like, Enigma beats Ursa in a 1v1 lane. You're going to deny every single range creep, and there's nothing Ursa can do about it. Ursa's going to get no experience from any range creep. How's mid lane going?
Mid lane, Kingfisher, Pisces. Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be pretty boring.
He did start Juan.
Yeah, we're good. unlike the Tusk in our game, who didn't buy Juan versus Bristleback. Interesting choice. I think that this mid lane only goes poorly for either of them if Pango overextends. I think Bats can't lose this lane, but Pango can't really win it, you know.
I think Pango, he's just look, I mean, 6 stacks. It feels so bad.
And at this point,
holy shit, up top,
Pango. I would walk away. Yo, they first spotted? Dang.
Kenny walks up a little bit too far forward and Alk with the sprout is able to just trap him in and kill him.
Oh, Morana was so... Look how close Morana was to level 2. If he got... If they denied one less creep or they got one more last hit, like, he has level 2 and he can leap out of there and doesn't get first blood.
Meanwhile, down bottom, Doc Hammer getting trapped up in the shards by buying onions. Montreal coming in, just gonna start hitting him up, scaring him off. Warlock will live.
This is the... Enigma versus Ursa, I think, is an Enigma favored lane because you can deny every range creep, but you can't ever challenge because Ursa, until you get level 6, like Ursa just kind of hits you and there's nothing you can do about it.
That's why I would have liked to see something other than this Warlock. If you have a little bit more aggressive support, you can just
walk
at the Enigma.
If you have like a Crystal Maiden or like, you know, any like stunner hero, you know. But right now Ursa's being punched.
Getting
up. Oh, Ursa, I didn't think about this. Ursa's actually pretty good versus Tusk because you can leap over the shards. Actually not bad.
If you have the directional move key mount.
Okay, I feel like if you're playing Ursa or Slark or Shadow Fiend or any of those heroes, like I think you need, or Pango,
it's,
I think you need.
And it's
it,
also
know?
It's a lot harder than you think too. Like,
it can't be that hard. I play Zeus. It can't be that hard.
Zeus is easy because you just face the direction and then you, Zeus is easy, but.
Oh, okay. Oh, the hero I play is easy, but the heroes you play are hard. Yeah.
Well, because Zeus leap shoves you further.
That's true. Ursa Leap is very short, but
it makes it
easier to hit. Like a little bit. Yeah, you need to be like right at the edge to get over it.
And the clicking, making sure to click it while also still getting that, as Stockhammer is just going to get walked at by buying against Eidolon.
Dude, dang. This is like... I really think this Warlock pick was really bad, to be honest. I think they should have picked either a more aggressive support or like a save support, like, you know, like an Abaddon or like an Oracle or something like that.
Something that can actually sit back. Pisces dives the mid tower, going in on Kingfisher.
Okay.
He will end up dying to the tower afterwards, but...
That's a huge kill for Pisces, actually, because, like, you want to be the guy who dies second in that engagement mid. It actually matters a lot, because you get all the experience for it, which is a huge deal. Like, look at Pango, he's more than half a level behind Batrider right now. Pisces is... I mean, as Pisces should be, he's owning this lane. Top lane also is kind of going disastrously for Radiant. Like, the Marauder give up that first blood, and since then...
Prophet has 11 denies.
Yeah, dude, this is like...
He has more denies than the Enigma.
Dude, wait, you're right! He almost has more denies than last hits. This lane is going horribly for Radiant.
This is...
Granted, Alk is a very high MMR player,
Holy shit,
This lane's way
down bottom, they do the exact same thing.
Wow. This is...
Shards, Bunions get Snowball.
This Radiant, I think this Radiant draft needed to win in lanes to win the game, and...
It needed to be able to win in lanes. And come out with at least, I think, Sand King Blink and Ursa not.
Ursa not having fed. Ursa, like, Battle Fury would be ideal. If he leaves the lane with a Battle Fury, that's completely ideal.
Honestly,
I think
you don't even go Battle Fury this game.
Have to versus Nature's Prophet. I actually think you, like, absolutely have to. Because Nature's Prophet will get 20. He'll get 20 very fast because he's going to have, like, infinite farm. And, oh, maybe top lane? They're actually going on him right now.
Getting gone on here by the Kenny, but Kenny is no mana, no leaps. It's
leap,
just enough for the leap. We'll get away, but...
What's funny is Alec lost 75% of his HP there, and then Tree pressed armor on him, and he started losing zero more HP because it gives a million armor and a million regen. That spell is really dumb.
Totally, totally legit spell. So, as long as... So, honestly, the Ursa... The Ursa pick would have been fine. You have a bit better support who doesn't just get walked at by Tusk Enigma. Yeah.
I think really grouped them.
Tusk kind of coming mid.
They might be able to kill. They
Pisces
can definitely...
has 6. Pisces has 6. I think they are looking to set up, but he did get scattered out by this Observer Ward that just despawned.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. He would have gotten the D Ward too because he knew about it.
Kingfisher gets a bottle refill.
Yeah, I don't think you can kill him when the Mirana's here. Right, maybe if Mirana leaves though.
Now, Pharmacist. Deciding to go in on ZyQ, there's dust on him. He is dusted. Alc might just decide to start hitting.
Alc is AFK farming, bro. Alc is. Bro, Alc. He's like, fuck you, I'm playing my game. I'm getting the gold.
Dude,
he has 16 denies. He actually has 16 denies. It feels so sad to be the Sand King.
Really is. I'm looking at the last hits too. Like, you look at the Radiant last hit denies, and you just see 3-3, and then you see 16-16.
I will say Pango actually, despite having died and despite being up against Batrider, actually doing pretty well mid. He has 28 last hits. That's actually not bad. That's perfectly respectable.
He has 28 last hits, and he's also right on par with the Batrider in net worth. That's one thing. It's like dying those early deaths can matter a little bit, but
in mid it matters a lot for levels. Like it matters a ton for levels. Like Bat's level advantage is pretty much exclusively from that kill.
Yes.
The CS are like identical, so it's just from that kill. Okay. Kingfisher has to be a little careful here. If he does that again, I think
careful.
He dies.
He only has 11, and that burn damage really starts to hurt. ZyQ might get caught out as Kenny's pulling the wave, doing some wave shenanigans.
Yeah, Zai did just die. Hopefully
I'm
guessing
he got Sanking stunned arrows.
Yeah, he got Burrow Strike arrowed, and you're just dead at that point. Granted, he's giving Alc the freest lane of his life.
Montreal Osaka gets gone on by buying onions again. Just shards, trap, snowball. And
this bot lane is a disaster for Radiant. Enigma has Midas. Enigma already has Midas. Holy shit.
Yeah, dude, 6 Eidolons, and he has Midas. He didn't use it. All right, now he does.
With a massive Midas. Yeah, these lanes are not going well for Radiant at all. Radiant, like... I think they really need to come, because they have no building damage, so they have to come out of lanes ahead, or you won't be able to take objectives, like, ever. Oh, Ursa comes mid. Ursa has had enough of his, having all of his range creep denied. He comes mid.
I don't know about this, because I think Batrider just... Yep.
Yeah, I think he does the exact same
Batrider
thing.
Batrider just lasses you now.
Batrider missed the kill, man? I think he still gets it, though. Yeah.
Oh, he decided that he didn't even need the lasso.
Yeah, he didn't want to use lasso. He can use lasso for the TPs here, yeah. This Ursa's game is just ruined.
Holy shit. That's 3 cores mid.
Mid, oh my god.
Oh, I guess Pango did
leave bottom. I'm gonna tell you from experience playing pub games, when you have a rotation of heroes mid, things are not going well. When several heroes are sitting mid, things are not going well for you. That's level 8.
That's level 8. There's a sentry down here that Pharmacist is standing in.
Yeah,
Isis does miss the stack. Holy shit. All right.
This Enigma is owning. He actually used Black Hole. He used Black Hole and straight up just killed the Pango.
That wasn't even any help from Tusk. It was just entirely Black Hole.
Yeah, and meanwhile, the Alkin's IQ combo, the two trees are pushing top lane. They already did half damage to this tower because Sand King left.
Dude, the Lettuce lane is too powerful.
Lettuce lane.
It's too powerful, dude.
Oh, meanwhile, Ursa is resigned to the jungle. That feels so bad.
Resigned to the jungle. Pharmacist gets slowed up by the creep. That feels bad. Montreal Osaka here, under vision. Pisces is coming over.
Oh my god. If Ursa dies again, this game is over. You can call GG at this point. Yeah, this is not looking good.
And yep, with the tag team, it's just gonna be Pisces killing Montreal Osaka. Ah, dude, feels bad as this, Ursa.
This is... You got Enigma laned, and then...
You get Enigma laned, you don't have...
You can't go to top lane because the NP and Treant will just, like, click you out of lane, you know? Because they both have 80 damage and they're...
Three bounties. Alk, please.
Did he just walk past three? Oh, he's doing the... He's waiting for his Batrider to get them all. He's a full refill. They're going on top, though.
Going up top, they do manage to... Oh wait, no, he dove tower and just died.
He tower to try to kill the Perseus IQ, but...
Oh no.
I'm sorry, but that's a Treant. You're not... It's a Treant with level 3. Tanky,
and they have BOTs on Batrider, so you're every single rotation you make, they're gonna have plus 1 in Batrider and plus 1 in Nation Prophet, you know? So yeah. Every rotation, you gotta bring...
I mean, that wasn't even Prophet. Prophet, Alex is entirely fucked off to the jungle. Javelin and Backpack, dude. Come on.
Javelin Backpack over the Iron Branch. Very important you have that Iron Branch instead.
Over the Fairy Fire, bro. Eat the Fairy Fire. Oh, Alk TPing
bottom
now.
I will say, this bad TPing top is actually nice for Ursa. Ursa gets a lane now.
Holy shit, Kingfisher rotates top and they manage to find IQ. Meanwhile, down bottom, Alk has come to just Omega push this tower.
Omega push the tower with fucking Enigma. This is having building damage and having no building damage. Radiant has no building damage, they can't ever take objectives.
Yeah, like, so even though they've killed this IQ.
Yeah. Look at this top, like, if this was a pushing hero, if this was a Leshrac, this tower is dead already. But right now, they're TPing in here to get kills because this tower is still alive.
Tower's still
alive. And
they're
gonna heal it forever with the IQ.
Oh, Alk has... Oh, no, Alk does not have TP. Dude, Alk, buy a TP scroll.
Ooh, wow. The real greedy P1. Don't buy TP scroll. I'm not coming to your fucking ganks. What do you think I am?
Looks like, are they gonna smoke up mid? No, they're gonna Murana ulti, it looks like. Trying to defend his mid tower, but...
Warlock has a smoke in his backpack.
Okay, Alk and Brody need to stop.
They're 5-man TPing for the Sand King, who is already dead. This game is looking rough.
Did he get lassoed? Yeah, he got lassoed, so...
Yeah.
I'm missing so many of the kills, but it's okay. I'm tired. I'm not, actually. I took a
shot. Yeah, these kills are pretty heavy.
Kingfisher getting rolled on by Tusk. Does get stunned. No shards available.
There is Black Hole available, so they can Black Hole, but...
I mean, why?
This is the counter.
You just threaten the Black Hole and take the tower.
Warlock just got a 6, though. Oh. The counter to Black Hole is online. Did Warlock buy Tome for that, or did... I think Warlock got the tone.
I'm gonna guess that he did because Kenny is also about the same level.
Yeah.
Warlock has not been having a good game.
I don't see a world in which Radiant ever takes an objective other than Roshan because Ursa.
Warlock just feels like such a useless hero right now, unless you go the upheaval build. I played against a pause for Warlock who just. Like maxed upheaval in lane. Dude, it's so toxic. You try and walk up to deny or last hit in the melee.
You're
hero,
for,
you
yeah,
just
you're for 50%.
You can't move.
I will say I think the Warlock pick is totally justified if you see Enigma and you go,
yes.
Okay, let's pick Warlock and counter him by being a worse silencer.
Yeah.
But at this point, just pick the freaking silencer, you know? Like. Rubick. I think they could have picked Rubick here and been a lot better served. I guess they first picked Warlock, but why are you first picking Warlock? That seems bad.
Three man jungling. Like, especially, like, if you're gonna first pick a hero, Make sure it's a hero that does shit.
Yeah, I agree.
Murana, it does shit.
I think it's often way better to first pick a P4 than a P5, just because of this reason. Because your P5, you want to have flexibility in your P5, because they're often the ones who are countering the enemy.
Shard by buying onions, just kind of walking at Doc Hammer, but Montreal is in the area, and it might just cost him his life.
Rock for it.
It will. Meanwhile, I see a lasso. I hear a lasso. Icy's finds a Murana.
This is the dream Batrider game. You don't need a Blink Dagger this game, I'm bad. Like, you can just go fucking BOT's BKB, you know, and
yeah, your team's gonna catch them for you.
Yep, exactly. This is the dream Batrider game. And every single enemy core is a melee hero. Like, this is the dream Batrider game.
So, one for one on the supports.
Sand King does have a Blink Dagger, so they do have an item timing, but he's also very low, and it seems very hard to make a play with the Sand King at a quarter HP.
Trying to arrow against this team also just... Oh my god. There is a sentry down, so he is going to be spotted here. Sebastian is falling really low, though. But nice save by buying onions.
Oh my god. Actually, that's so much more damage than I thought it would be. The tusk... It's just so much damage.
Now, Prophet is in top here.
Tusk juke the arrow.
They do see Kenny. He's going to get caught out here again. He has no more leaps, and it's going to cost him his life. Prophet here kind of hurts.
If you're Dire, you know that Warlock ult's down. You know the Black Hole is free right now. If you press Black Hole, no one can cancel it. They're just going to take the tower. They're being satisfied by taking every objective in the entire game.
Yeah, all right. Montreal Sokka did hear me. He's not going to the battle fury. He is grabbing up the Azob.
Oh my god,
Sand King blinks into the black hole. And it costs him his life. However, he did get a nice double stun onto little Sebastian now. As now the Ursa coming in, but he gets rooted up by ZyQ, and that will be his life going down.
This game is looking over already. This is.
Holy shit, dude. He has Midas Greaves in 16 minutes on Sebastian. Doc Hammer sprouted up. Yeah.
Yep. Not much you can do with Warlock there. What does Warlock have? Warlock has no
items.
Not
a force staff.
Yep, that's what I was gonna say.
Not a force staff. Meanwhile, I think Pisces is done. He's got his BKB flying out on Courier.
Yeah, this is the dream Batrider game. You can be extremely greedy with your items, and none of the enemy force can punish you for it.
There is now a Blink Dagger on Tusk.
Oh my god, their P4 has a Blink Dagger? Dude, look at the net worth disparity between like the P4 on Dire and the P4 on Radiant. It's like 1,000.
They're 12k up already.
Yeah, 12k at 16 minutes. That's just... With a great pushing lineup like Dire have, there's no way you come back from this. They're gonna take every tower in the game.
Montreal Sokka does have the diffuse. He's going in on buying onions, but I believe that will cost him his life. His out comes in with the silence. And lasso. It's a short lasso. He doesn't wait, but it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, yeah. This Ursa has nothing but Diffusal Blade. No boots! This Ursa has no boots?
Yeah. He rushed the diff you out.
I don't like that at all. I think Ursa is one of the heroes that requires boots.
Tusk with the Blink Dagger just blinks on, finds Doc Hammer. It's like you and them. I think this game's pretty over.
I don't blame Doc Hammer for this. I blame him for maybe the draft. I don't know who drafted my team, but...
I think it was Doc.
I think his Warlock pick was really bad. Needs a
hand. Sorry guys, it's hard to cast Stomp because people die so fast that I can't get the camera over there.
It's true.
It's like, oh fuck, there's a Tusk. Oh well, he's dead. I can tell you what happened. Pharmacist passes Blink. He's gonna blink out. Pisces does spot him. Gets the nice knockback catch on Pharmacist, and with the Tusk there, it's gonna cost him his life.
They're unstoppable. Tonage.
Oh no, Pisces gets a haste rune.
How long is lasso?
50.
40 seconds. Okay. They're probably just gonna go with that timing. I bet they get one more pick with the lasso.
This does not feel good. Why are your mid and carry just both farming
a
stack?
Yeah, they're both farming triangle. Yeah. They're going to rush right now. This is the objective taking power that Dire has. This is why you need like objective gamers. They can take Roshan and...
Going to the Rosh, really you got this Guardian Greaves for all your summons.
Yep.
As they it's a nice 4-man ulti, but little Sebastian gets a 3-man Chrono.
You've got a whole
4-man
for the Black Hole.
More than 2 kills. Pharmacist, he's like, I'm gonna go in and, you know, use what I got. There is a sentry down. Pharmacist is spotted, and there's not much you can do about that. Ursa Bai, what?
Ursa Bai pack. Oh no. This Ursa, Tusk almost has more net worth than the Ursa does. This is so sad. Ursa's still no, I think you are required to have boots on Ursa. I am amazed that he doesn't have boots yet.
You need boots, but honestly, if you have a rough lane, you just get the, power treads. Go jungle. You get power treads and jungle.
Yeah, I agree. It makes you jungle a hell of a lot faster. And also, it makes you move, I think one of the most important things is it makes you move between camps faster. Like, right now, it's taking
not even shipping out boots.
Twice as long to move between camps than it should.
Gonna smoke.
He's solo one-man smoke.
Oh, he gets broken by buying onions. Spots him with the ward, dude. I think Tusk can solo kill
him. Oh my god, I think Tusk can actually solo kill him. This is not...
I will say, though, there is a Radiant sentry, so they saw this. Ops.
They will get a free...
But it's not gonna matter.
Dire's gonna take this Roche and never give them their triangle back in the rest of the game. The objective is take Roche and sit in the triangle and hold it for the rest of the game. Because they know how far behind Radiant is. The Penguin is the only one who's had a good game so far.
Doc Hammer. It's like, yes, I can finally go get a ward.
If I was the shot caller for Dire,
oh, Kingfisher gets spot down bottom. Alk has the root and silence.
Oh, and
this is just a dead Pango.
Yeah.
I don't think Zai needed to ult there. I think he was just dead to Orchid.
Yeah, that's fair. I think it's fine to ult there because it is their mid laner, and he's the only core in Radiant who is having an at least okay game. Ursa walks up and presses in rage. First thing, he doesn't nothing else, just presses in rage immediately.
Snowball save. There's Eidolons dead. Hitting him.
Yep, I think he's just dead.
Stunned. Alk?
Ouch, this sucks.
What happened? Wait, what? Oh, Alk found Kenny in the back.
Oh, with the oil, Pisces gets a free kill.
Oh, he's the full Gleipnir done now. That's why.
Yeah, he's got 14,000 net worth. Like, holy shit, this guy's probably got 900 GPM.
That was me, dude. This was me last week on the first game,
true?
Game one.
Alright, Sand King did TVX. Sand King is, he's got a blink dagger or nothing
got
else.
A blink
but
dagger, but like, I don't think he kills.
I don't think you can solo kill. Oh,
Pisces
God.
Has a BKB too.
I think you need to wait for your entire team to be up. I think like Pango roll plus Rock plus Sand King ult might kill Batrider, maybe.
No, he's got BKB. And you don't have chain stuns to keep him locked.
Yeah, and they have, this is another issue with Radiant Draft. They have no, like Sand King's gonna blink Burrow Strike you, and they have no chain stun to follow up with that. Like, the only stun they have for that is Morana ult, or Morana arrow, but that's like not a reliable setup, you know?
It's 20k net worth, god.
Yeah, I think this is a very clean out draft, and then they won every lane, and for Radiant to have any chance here, they had to win basically every lane, and they lost everyone. So.
For them to have had any chance, I would have liked to have seen the DP.
Yeah, I think a DP would have been great here. I also think the Sand King hero is a little awkward. I don't know. It's I guess Sand King Morana is a good lane. I would prefer to see.
Flying Onions just standing still, Gazeroed.
Yeah, he doesn't care. He doesn't give a shit. What are they gonna do?
I mean, it's just like it's the mental damage, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're like
Dire has good obs here. This obs in the bottom jungle from Dire is really nice. This ward is hard to find, and also it gives great vision for when you're corralled in your base like this. You can if anyone walks out of their base into this area, you can just grab them and kill
them.
Yeah,
you can see because you know you, as long as you're pushing in the other two waves, you know, like you'll know where they are.
Yeah, exactly. And Radiant has, or Dire has no issues putting in, pushing another
Pharmacist, they're outside of their base and it does not feel good. Like, Alk is just here with ZyQ and there's Bat keeping in, misses the overgrowth. Nice Burrow Strike out by Farm. But
honestly, this is fine for Dire. Like,
Montreal
oh, yeah,
is,
yeah, just that's great. But even just like scaring them off is great because you're just corralling them in their base. They're getting no farm.
Versus
you know,
feeding.
They,
how many deaths does he have?
Ursa now has
nine.
Less net worth.
He has
than
nine
Tusk.
Deaths on Ursa.
That's yeah. He has less net worth than Tusk does. It's very hard to play that now. So, still no boots. I think this is such a big mistake. No,
Pisces just walks up. He's just gonna like, I'm gonna blast whoever I see.
I'm just gonna grab the first person I see. Warlock instantly buys back.
That's a rage buyback.
Yeah, it's either rage or maybe someone on their team, maybe Pharmacist is saying, hey guys, look, I've got blink. We can make a miraculous play with Golem.
They weren't committing to high ground. You know, like, you're not gonna be able to catch them.
And I think if Dire were smart here, they won't actually go high ground with this Aegis. They'll wait next Aegis and just go high ground with the second Aegis.
Yeah, looking at Alk, I think that's his plan. He's got 50 seconds left. He's finished up a Satanic.
Trying for a smoke here on Radiant, and they will land it. Oh,
misses the arrow, just barely walks out, and he is gonna just walk away. There's still no boots on Ursa.
From the no boots Ursa, from the 300 movement speed Ursa. Oh, no.
They do see him here, and they get a nice snowball save though.
Very much a mistake.
Yeah, he's like, all right, I have Aegis, take me.
Right, he respawns, but Batten is now gonna TP in, and they do have Black Hole.
Tango is going in on Lil Sebastian, zoning him out. Although Ursa just does not win the man fight with the Satanic belt.
The NP is 1v5ing, literally.
He does get Warlock Golem here, and they have another stun.
They will kill
Alcoff. However, it costs them.
Cost them their P1 and their P2. And unfortunately, the one who got the kill, who got the 1,000 gold, was the Mirana. Oh, but Mirana, the P4 Mirana, has built a Maelstrom. This is now turning into a core Mirana because he has all of the farm.
I think he was just going for a Gleipnir. Although he did just build Phase Boots.
Yeah, no, I think this is going to be a core Mirana because they're like, fuck, guys, we need... If we're going to win this game, we need
to
have...
Mirana almost has as much nowhere as this.
This Ursa is so sad. I think this... Montreal Osaka must just not know that he doesn't. You must not realize he doesn't have boots because I cannot think of another reason. Although, how can you not realize it when you're moving this slowly? I don't know.
It's like, I have Diffuse. I don't need boots. I can slow them.
This is definitely. I can't tell if this is an intentional decision or not, but it's definitely a very bad decision if it's in.
Please replace your Quelling with just brown boots.
Yeah, literally. Like, watch him walk around and, like. It's so hard to get from camp to camp. It's so hard to go on anyone. If he had caught the Nature's Prophet,
Pharmacist
earlier,
is spotted out here mid. They don't have dust. They do have dust. First strike out, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. Yeah, he gets lasted.
Ooh, the arrow does land. Actually, maybe they can turn this. The
arrow landed on him, but Pisces is just gonna BKB walk away. Pharmacist lives, and Alk is leading the supports.
Alk is killing every single support in the game.
And now Kingfisher, with his roll in, is now left behind. Nothing left to save himself. Nice walk away from the arrow by buying onions. Does have Gleipnir up again. I think he could have gone on Kenny if he wanted to. He's going to hit tower.
At this point, though, if you're Dire, there's no reason to even take risks. You know, you can just kind of save.
Buying onions is going to go down here with a nice blink stun from Pharmacist. Pisces getting half health, but...
One criticism of Dire I do have is that this is something I see a lot with support players in general, and like lower MMR players in general. This Tusk, the P4 Tusk walked up and started hitting the tower, which I think is a huge mistake.
Especially
like,
if you have Blink.
What Zaiku is doing here is perfect. Zaiku is sitting in the back, he's ready to counter-engage if they go on his cores, but he knows that if they go on him, he dies. I think the Tusk made a really big mistake by walking up there, and that kind of stuff can throw games.
Especially the fact that, like, this is a Tusk with Blink. Like,
yeah, exactly.
You have that instant save, you have that instant disable.
So I do think, I mean, granted, that's like the only criticism I have of Dire this game. They've executed their plan perfectly, but it actually does. It
I don't
does
know,
really
I think Alk being alone in the triangle and, like, not having his team come over to him is a bit of a feat, but.
Fair. I think if I were the Batrider here, I probably would have built Octarine after I built BOT2s. I think BOT2s are so value here on Batrider.
I don't think you need them. You have Treants and Eidolons.
I guess you have Treants, that's fair. But like the Radiant actually does have good ways of killing Treants with Sand King and with Fatal Bonds. The Treants die very quickly. It's very hard to TP on them because you can't fort them like you can fort lane creeps.
Pipe Greaves. Basic fort. It's basically a fort, dude.
Well, I'm just saying, with Bat, BOT2s, you can... BOT's on to Nature's Prophet when he TP's.
Holy shit, Buying Onions does the better thing this time. He stands back and blinks forward.
This is why you stand in the back. This is exactly why you stand in the back. That was perfect. That was great.
And now with roll committed.
Yeah, that was their only... Sand King was dead during that, too, so there's nothing they can really counter-engage with. This might be the
last look Radiant gets their Buying Onions has a Deso, by the way, on the toss.
Oh, you're kidding me.
You went Blink Deso.
Oh my god, he's so rich, actually. He's almost richer than Sand King now.
And yep, Dire not taking any chances. They're just going to go close this out with Megas.
Yep. Gold and sweet. Yeah, I think if you push... I think you push high ground here, like, and try to take tier 4, there's like a 0.1% chance you lose. I think if you do this, there's a 0% chance you lose.
I get silenced up. Lasso pulling on the IQ blinks in, finds Pharmacist, but Pharmacist does have Grease, he's just gonna walk away. Pisces, BKB onto nothing.
Live in tier 4s.
Oh, he has a gem, he just doesn't have Lasso, that's what it was.
I will say, I think Pisces made a really good choice here. He went on the Warlock, which you might think is like, it's their P5, it's whatever. Actually, it's a really important part of their team fight is the Fatal Bonds, plus it's the only Black Hole cancel they have.
Yeah, it's their only Black Hole. Well, I mean, he doesn't have BKB on Enigma, so... But, yeah, GG called.
Yeah, that's GG, and the game has been over for a long time, but...
It's been over since, like, 15 minutes.
The game's over in the draft, honestly. They really drafted themselves into a corner there, I think. A really well played Euthanasia Coaster. They dominated this game.
Good job, So a stomp for a stomp, and hopefully this one did actually get game one for them didn't get ticketed.
Yeah, I reminded Alk at the beginning of this game to ticket the game so that he wouldn't forget it. Let me look at the net worth graph of this game.
True.
Yeah. I'm actually surprised it took them until 10 minutes to get that advantage because I thought they left the lane with like a 6k advantage or something like that.
Yeah. I mean, well, so in the thing is that in the lane, you know, like, Pango had kept up in farm, Pharmacist had kept up in last hits, you know, like, the only one who hadn't was Osaka, and that's just because that's he's against an Enigma, and he's died a couple times. I think
the Pango actually did really well mid. I was actually surprised. Like, that's a losing matchup for Pango mid.
He was playing really good.
Yeah, he played really well. He played that really, really well.
I think they just griefed themselves with the safe lane of Warlock.
Yeah,
Warlock Ursa.
Also, I think the Sand King did fine in lane. I mean, he lost the lane, but it wasn't too bad.
It's a lane you lose. You're not able to, like, especially because I think it was Mirana Kenny could not win the Ward War with ZyQ.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And if you're not winning the Sentry War, it just feels bad as Sand King because.
Yeah, because you always are seeing, and you get hit by Nature's Prophet and all the Treants.
So
I think you need a building damage hero though. I think it was just an outdraft. I think you need a building damage hero.
Well, right after lanes here, 10 minutes, both teams make this rotation to that safe lane tower. They both get a kill, and then they start to pressure the tower.
One team takes it, one team doesn't. You know.
And because they have this Pango Sand King, neither of them can hit the tower.
Yeah, and Tree just armors it, and it survives through every hero.
They killed
the
Tree. They killed the Tree, but Tree respawned before they even did 25% damage.
Yeah. And I think you, so it feels you're, like... I think Leshrac would have been great for them this game.
Leshrac DP.
Yeah. I think Leshrac especially, because they have so many summons on the Dire that Leshrac is really good against summons, because you put a summon in front of Leshrac, and he lifesteals and gets mana off of it. You know, it's really hard to play against Leshrac with summons heroes.
All right, and I think that'll do it for us on the cast. Thank you for casting with me, Nate.
Yeah, for sure. Thanks for having me on. Good 1-1 series too.
Very good series, I guess. Although
Archie's also, we're playing a pub if you want to get in here.
I'm done.